Praise the Lord, good morning. Greetings in the mighty name of Jesus, and it is a joy and a privilege to be here the third Sunday morning to minister the Word of God. God is a wonderful God. He's great and mighty, amen. Praise the Lord, I know the coronavirus is still hitting our world, although we have the vaccine, but I know that hundreds of thousands have died before the vaccine is being reached to everyone before they receive it in their arm. But let's continue to pray, and let's also remember America in prayer. Today is the 17th of January. Within the 17th to the 20th, I can see in the spiritual realm that America is facing great danger. Thing is there on edge. And I pray that everything will be done decently and in order. Because America is the superpower of the world. And all eyes are on America. The world is depending upon America. If America falls, the entire world will fall also. Praise the Lord. That's enough for politics this morning. Praise God. This morning I'd like to minister the Word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. But before I get into the Word this morning, let's all have a word of prayer. Father God, this morning I give you praise, I give you glory, I give you honor, I give you thanks. I thank you for your love and your grace and your mercy and your great concern and the working of the Holy Spirit. I pray, God, this morning you dip me in the river of liquid fire of the Holy Spirit. Anoint my lips, anoint my tongue, anoint my body, anoint my soul, anoint my mental faculties, my thought process. Let the fire of God, like on the day of Pentecost, come upon my head. And help me as I minister your words, that many will be healed, many will be saved, many will be blessed, many will be delivered. And many will come to know thee as Lord God and Savior. Into thy hands I come with your words and I come with my life. I ask in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. Amen. God is good all the time. And he is indeed a wonderful and powerful God. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I always say times may change, circumstances may change, situation might change, laws may change, constitutions may change, presidents for countries may change and will change. But Jesus never changes. He is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. The God of truth, the God of holiness, and the God of righteousness. Praise the Lord. This morning my message is entitled, the last message, and in fact sometime during the year, I think for the part, I preach on, Devil Drop Your Gun, it's 2021. And this morning I like to preach on, When the Devil Runs for Cover. When the Devil Runs for Cover. My friends, this morning, you may have done everything you know to do. You've obeyed the voice of the Lord. You've taken a stand by faith. I'm not doubting you this morning. Probably you have already taken a stand of faith this morning. Hallelujah. But my friends, no matter what you do, you've bound the devil. Loose the angels, commanded, declared and prayed. In your heart, you know that you can have victory in these circumstances. Some way, somehow, you can't beat it with the power of God. Some way, somehow, there's a loophole, there's a crack, and you can't beat it with the power of God. What's happening? Hallelujah! But still, my friends, you find yourself trapped in defeat. Instead of being overtaken by the blessings of God, some portion of the curse is clinging to you this morning. I say some portion of the curse is still clinging to you this morning. Hallelujah. It might be sicknesses or lack or failure, relationship, fearfulness, being a coward, being a jellyfish with no spine and no backbone, or business dealings. Went south. But whatever it is this morning, It is clearly of the devil, and it is sticking to you like gum on your shoe. It is sticking to you, but I want to tell you, it is 2021. Release the gum from the shoe. Release the gum from your life. It's 2021. It's time to move on, my friends. Spiritually, you're smart enough to realize that God is not your problem this morning. He's on your side, and neither he nor his words ever fails this morning. God never fails. I says he's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Things may fail, people may fail, but Jesus will never fail, my friend. You might be tempted to believe the devil is your problem, but the fact is this morning, my friends, you know better than that too. Jesus whipped him completely 2,000 years ago and took away all his authority. Yes, 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ defeated the devil on the cross of Calvary, and he took all his power and authority. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The question is, my friends, this morning, if God isn't the problem and the devil isn't the problem this morning, who is? Who is the problem this morning for your defeat and failure? Who is the problem? Who is? If you found yourself wondering that lately, my friends, don't feel bad. Every believer who has ever walked by faith for more than a week or two has asked that question. Yes, they have all asked that question sometime before in our lives. At one time or another, we've all found ourselves unable to succeed for a reason we don't understand. We don't understand sometimes. Oh, and we find ourselves in situations which we don't understand. But the lesson is in the receptacles this morning. Receptacles, why is that this morning? It's because for the most part, we have been gaps by the basic spiritual operating principles this morning of this planet, my friends. We have learned a little about the force of faith in the principles of God. But there are more going on here than that. A lot more upon this earth, my friends. The Antichrist spirit is here. The spirit of deceit. The spirit of lies. The spirit of fraud. The spirit of lawlessness. The spirit of wickedness is loose upon the face of the earth. Has been outpoured as never before. The Antichrist spirit is in this world today. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah this morning. Hallelujah. It's because we have grasped the basic principles. Yes, my friends, operating in this planet. And we must learn. We must learn a little about the forces of faith and the principles of God this morning. But there are more, my friends, I repeat it. There's more going on. More going on than that. A lot more in this world today, my friends. You see, beloved, for every force and principle God has created, there exists a receptacle this morning. Receptacle this morning, when God first told me that, I had to get out of my dictionary and look up the word receptacle. Yes, to find out exactly what that means. I found it referring to something that corresponds to something else, but in reverse or inverted, the receptacle of north, for example, is south. North and south are both directions on the compass. The difference is one is the opposite of the other. No matter how far you go north, the moment you turn around, you will be going south. Yes, because you will be going south because they are receptacles this morning. Receptacles. If you were the navigator of a ship, you will be at a greater disadvantage, my friends, if you don't know south exists. Won't you? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! If the only direction you were aware of was south, you will get off track very easily. That sounds silly, but the truth is, Many Christians are trying to do that very thing in the realm of the spirit. They are trying to navigate by faith without taking into consideration the reciprocal force and that can and will take them into opposite direction. And if they do not guard against it, my friends, what is that? If they do not guard against it, my friends, what is this reciprocal force I'm talking about this morning? You might ask that question this morning. It is the force of fear. The force of fear is gripping many today. Many are living in fear. Fear is not of God. Fear is of the devil. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind this morning. Let's always remember that. Fear is not of God this morning. Fear is not of God. Hallelujah. God has not given us a spirit of fear. Hallelujah. And we must understand it. That's the truth, my friends. Hallelujah. We must guard about it. Oh, you might say, oh, I don't feel like I'm afraid of anything. You may say, that doesn't really matter because fear is not a feeling. It is not, my friends, an emotion. It is a spiritual force. And although it can and does affect your emotions, it can be in operation even when you don't feel it. And we must understand the word of God. Hallelujah. If God isn't the problem, let's remember, if God isn't the problem and the devil isn't the problem, then who is the problem? Who is this morning? To understand how powerful fear can be, you must first realize that the devil didn't create it. He can't create anything. I say the devil cannot create anything this morning. Hallelujah. He cannot create anything. Hallelujah. The devil cannot create anything, my friends. He is not a creator. He's just a fallen angel. And the Bible says there is no truth in him. According to John chapter 8 verse 44. If you have ever originated anything this morning, it will be the truth, and the truth shall set you free. God is truth this morning, but he hasn't this morning. All he can do is take what God has created and pervert it this morning. So that's exactly what he does, my friend. He takes the powerful principles God put in force to bless mankind and twist them so they work in reverse and bring a curse instead. Hallelujah. This is 2021. You have to break the curses. Hallelujah. Every forces of darkness. It's 2021. Faith reverse become a curse. That's what happened in the Garden of Eden. Before the devil got involved, Adam and Eve were living in total blessing. They were ruling with authority God has given them over a planet that was governed by one master law, the law of the spirit of life. Heaven and earth were spiritually connected by the word of God. So everything good that comes from that divine life flow freely without obstruction. What happened, my friends? You know the story. The devil came and questioned the word of God. He said to Eve, yea, had God said. He said to Eve, yea, had God said. Then once he had her attention, he flatly contradicted God's word. Ye shall not surely die, he says in Genesis 3:2-4. He deceived Eve in breaking fellowship with God and his word through disobedience. We have so many disobedient people in our world today. Disobedience is sin, my friends. Adam followed suit. Although he knew better, the Bible tells us by the time that he was done, the devil had gained dominion over mankind. I said by the time Adam finished, the devil had already gained dominion over mankind, my friends. Yes, he had already gained dominion over mankind. And therefore, the earth God has given to them to rule, he had taken the master law of the spirit of life and perverted it into his reciprocal, the law of sin and death. My friends, under the law of sin and death, every blessing becomes a curse. The
ground which at once produced abundant being is to withhold its fruits and prosperity become perverted. Yes, become poverty. Hallelujah. Health turned to sickness. Success became failure. Victory turned to defeat. What more fit? The creative power of God that had given to man to use, rule the earth, became fear. Man is living in fear today, afraid to make decisions. No spine, no backbone, no guts, no belly. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So far, so when God came walking in the garden in the cool of the day to fellowship with man, Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden, my friends. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, "Where art thou?" Hallelujah. "Where art thou?" And he says, "I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid." Adam was afraid. Why was he afraid? Because his conscience pricked him. He knew he sinned. He knew he disobeyed God. Hallelujah. And he was afraid, according to Genesis 3, 8 to 10. The Master Lord this morning, my friends, we must understand, but thankfully, that's not the end of the story. God didn't abandon the earth and leave man forever enslaved to the devil and the law of sin and death. He sent his only son in the form of man to reverse what Adam has done. He sent Jesus almost 2,000 years ago, and he bridged the gap between man and God to reconcile us back to himself. He died that we might have life. A life more abundantly. He died. He died for me and you that we might have life and life eternal. And he destroyed the works of darkness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, my friends. Yes, sir. But into hell itself to pay the price of sin and bear the penalty of it. Then by raising him from the dead, God reinstated the law of the spirit of life. For whosoever will believe in him. Romans chapter 8 verse 1 and 2 says it this way. Therefore is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. We are free. Whom the Son hath set free is free indeed. Are you free today? I want to tell you, if you're bound, if you're not free, Jesus Christ can set you free today, my friends. Hallelujah. He can set you free. Hallelujah. He can set you free. That means there are now two master's laws. Two master law function on the earth. God's original, which is a law of the spirit of life, and Satan's reciprocal of our counterfeit, which is a law of sin and death. Yes, my friends, as far as God is concerned, every believer has been delivered from Satan's law and all its effects. Hallelujah. Jesus has done everything necessary to set us free. Hallelujah. I said Jesus has done everything necessary to set us free. Yet in spite of that fact, the vestige of the curse often seems to dog the steps of many Christians because they unknowingly activate the law of sin and death and give the devil entrance to our lives. Yes, my friends, as Hosea 4 verse 6 says, they are destroyed for lack of knowledge. The Bible says they are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. My people perish, said the Lord, for the lack of knowledge. God says if you lack knowledge, acts of him, and he shall give unto thee liberally this morning. Do you lack knowledge this morning? Look at the chart below and see, hallelujah. Yes, sir. Hallelujah, this morning, if you look in our world today, I have a chart with me here today, and if I look at it clearly, I'm going to tell you, I didn't go to the blackboard, but I'm going to tell you today, my friends, hallelujah, I'm talking about there I've listed the two master laws along with their authors and some of the results they produced this morning. Notice they are each part corresponds with this reciprocal. It is the same yet opposite. The law of the spirit of life, the new birth. baptism of the Holy Spirit, righteousness, healing, prosperity, love, and success. The law of sin and death, Satan, spiritual debt, demonic oppression, unrighteousness, sickness, poverty, hate, failure. That's the two laws. This morning, my friends, study the first part of that list for a moment. What you will see, my friends, then you'll see if you can answer this question. What is a force that activates the law of the Spirit of life? It is faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, but evidence of things not yet seen. Faith, my friends, the just shall live by faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please the Lord. We receive the new birth by faith. We receive the baptism in the Holy Spirit by faith. We receive healing by faith. Nothing happens in the realm of life without faith. Now, applying the law of receptacles, you will see that since fear is satanic receptacle of faith, the law of sin and death is activated by fear. I said the law of sin and death is activated by the spirit of fear. Not just occasionally, but every time. Repent and get rid of it this morning. I said repent and get rid of it this morning. Well, I wasn't afraid and I sinned and I went bankrupt. And the devil stole everything, almost everything I had. Hallelujah. But my friends, that's impossible. My friends, I tell you, the devil cannot prevail in your life apart from fear any more than God can prevail in your life apart from faith. The Bible says, just as faith is the substance of things hoped for, according to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, fear is the substance of things not desired. Faith reaches into the unseen realm and the spirit of the spirit and manifests the promises of God. Fear reaches into the unseen realm and manifests the threats of the devil. Faith is the power God used to create. Fear is the power the devil used to destroy. Hebrews 2 verse 14, Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14, 15 says, because Jesus became flesh and blood, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death, that is the devil, and deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage. It is fear of death that keeps us in bondage. I say, my friends, it is a fear of death that keeps us in bondage. But God can release you, my friends, from that bondage today. Hallelujah. Yes, God can release you from that debt of bondage. You must understand, however, that the fear of death does not necessarily mean you're afraid to leave your body and head for heaven as believers do. When they died physically, you're probably looking forward to that day, my friends. The fear of death refers to, in Hebrews, has such a broader meaning than that, my friends, this morning. It includes the fear of sicknesses, lack, failure, hallelujah, everything else. It is included under the master law of sin and death. Hallelujah. If you grow up in a poor family, or for example, you might spend your lifetime in bondage and fear or poverty. You might even try to apply the principles of God, giving and confessing and doing all things that bring prosperity. But if you retain the underlying fear of being poor, it won't matter how much wealth you accumulate, the devil will rob you every time you turn around. Because the thief cometh, but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He keep on doing it until you go before God and repent of that fear and get rid of it this morning. The Bible says the same thing is true in sickness. If you're afraid of it, you can't expect to be sick. The fear will produce the sickness. So many times we just try to deal with the superficial fleshly manifestations of disease in our bodies. But sickness doesn't start with the flesh. The flesh is just where it ends up. As Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12 says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world. That, what does that mean? Use of word this morning. Fear, fear in there. Source of power. Fear is a source of power. When fear gets in you, you can make stupid decisions. You can be the biggest coward when fear gets in you. You can make some awkward decisions because of fear. Hallelujah. So if we take authority of it and break its power, the poverty, sickness, and failure that fear was designed to bring will never have the opportunity to manifest in our lives. You can take authority over fear, my friends, this morning. You know the devil will tell you that you can't. He will pet you and say, oh, you pity little thing. You are suffering so much, you can't help but be afraid. That's hogwash this morning. I say that's hogwash this morning. God says, fear not, more than 60 times in the Bible. He would have given us that commandment if we have the power to obey it, my friends. In the book of Psalms, chapter 118, verse 6, David says, the Lord is on my side, I will not fear. Notice he didn't say, I will pray and ask God to take the fear away. He didn't say, I'll try not to be afraid. He says, I will not fear. David says, I will not fear. Hallelujah. You got to be like David this morning. I will not fear. Don't be a wimp this morning. Don't be a coward. Don't be a spineless jellyfish without backbone this morning. The choice is yours. Refusing to fear is the first of all a matter of the will. But as the verse indicates, it is also the matter of choosing to believe that in every situation, God is on our side by His power. He will see us through. Hallelujah. He says, lo, I'm with you always, I will never leave you, nor forsake you even unto the end of the world. Of course, to successfully walk by faith and not fear, we need to know exactly how to trap into that power, my friends. According to 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 and 4 tells us, it says, God, divine power, hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of Him that hath called us to glory and virtue, whereby we are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises, my friends, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature. Yes, having escaped the corruption in this world through lust. Hallelujah. And where the Bible tells us in John chapter 2, verse 5 says, whosoever keepeth the word, in him verily is the love of God perfect, whereby know we that we are in him. Are you in him this morning, my friends? Then John chapter 4, verse 18 says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out all fear. Hallelujah. Yes, perfect love casteth out all fear. God makes available everything we could possibly need this morning. Every conceivable blessing through the promises in His words, my friend. If we believe them and activate the law of the Spirit of life, those promises will manifest in our lives. They will open the way for us to escape the destruction brought into the earth by the law of sin and death. Yes, my friends, Satan, however, challenges those promises with fear. He brings us contrary circumstances to convince us those promises can never come to pass. He tells us lies. The devil is a liar from the beginning. He's a cheat and a robber. He comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He contradicts the word of God and says, you'll never make it. He says, you'll never make it. You're too weak. Other folks can walk by faith because they're stronger than you. You don't have to be you don't have the background to, there's something wrong with you. Ah, my friends, the choice is yours. Really listen to the word of God or the lies of the devil. Well, you might say, Pastor, I'm not really listening to the devil. I believe the word of God, but I can't just forget what happened to me in the past. Yes, I can't just forget what happened to me in the past. I feared. I didn't receive my healing. I was mistreated. Hallelujah. I was mistreated. You better forget these things, my friends. You better but put them under the blood of Jesus and wash them away forever. If you don't, you'll find yourself meditating on them. And just as faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God, faith comes by hearing the word of the devil. Fear comes by hearing the word of the devil.